So welcome back to the shop, friends. You may have noticed I got my ears lowered. Maybe a little bit shorter than I would have liked, but Granddad always said there was, 10 days difference between a good haircut and a bad one. So today I want to share a video with you. This video was brought to you or sponsored by, or Google Chromebooks hired me to do a video. And they wanted me to talk a little bit about how the Google Chromebook works into my workflow on the homestead. I got to thinking about that and I thought, let's do something a little different today. I want to share something with you that maybe I don't think that I've shared in the past, and that is what it takes to produce these videos, kind of a behind the scene, a look inside my toolboxes for the video side of it. We've done so many videos on toolboxes and tools and traditional woodworking and chainsaws and kits, but almost I don't think I've done anything on my kit on what it takes to produce this content. I thought you might be interested in to see it and how the Chromebook is an essential part of that whole production component. These are my video toolboxes. Comes down to two. After years and years of doing videos, I have made a lot of mistakes, but I've got a pretty good system here and I can get everything that I need to do to produce my content in these two cases. The yellow one is just for the drone and the black one here is for the camera equipment and everything it takes to upload a video. The current drones, you know, maybe not an essential tool, but it has opened up a creativity and the ability and an ease of getting shots, especially for one-man bands like myself, where I do everything. I do all of the videoing, I do all the editing, all the filming. I don't have anyone to help me. So a drone has become like kind of a portable camera. I look at it as a portable tripod that I can move around from a remote control from my phone. So this is my drone kit. I use a Mavic Pro. I use 5 batteries and I do sometimes use those all up, and everything fits nice in this nano case. I've got my chargers, I can put my phone, extra propellers and all of that. So this is something that's been really nice for me. One thing that was a problem though is that I shoot most of my stuff on micro SD cards. And if we look, I got the wrong side. Once I'm done shooting with the drone, I have no idea what I got, or even if I got the shot that I wanted to. And so having the ability to view this has become very, very important. And I'll show you how I do that. And this is my main camera case here. And right on top, I keep my Google Chromebook. I'm very specific about what I keep in here because I'm oftentimes away from the house. I'll shoot in remote locations, I'll shoot in far portions of the property, and coming back just ruins my whole workflow, and having the Chromebook here gives me the ability to make sure that I always get the shots with the cameras that I use. So it has a micro SD reader in the side, and I can put this in here. And this goes the same for my action cameras. See, the problem with shooting with drones and action cameras is that there's no screen. There's no way to see if did you get the shot. And with the lights failing and you go back and you just want to edit and you haven't verified that you got the shot, everything is wasted. So this gives me the ability to view these things. And not only that, but when I insert the card, I can automatically use the Google Drive function, and it's automatically uploading via wireless through my router, and it's protecting my footage. So everything is sitting up there on the cloud waiting for me when I go back into my office to do my editing. But in addition to that, I can verify right here, did I get the shot? I can look at things in a nice big display and HD, and I can see, okay, so I got the shot. So here's just a little bit of some footage from a Christmas video that I'm working on right now, where I had no idea did I get it? I couldn't see it. So, and this was a long ways from home. This was, you know, an hour away from home where I was getting this. So having the Chromebook and being able to verify this and to be sure that I had everything and to save everything up to the cloud and have it there waiting for me was really, really handy. And it's just become an essential component for me. The tripods that I use are made by Pro Media Gear. These are carbon fiber tripods that are professional grade tripods. And I have, I tried to skimp on tripods back in the day, and I had a couple fall over and damage very expensive equipment, and it really caused me problems. So I don't skimp on that anymore. This is the foundation of your whole thing. And when you start mounting expensive cameras with nice lenses up there, you have to have a stable tripod. I use Manfrotto video heads so I can get nice smooth pans. And having a sturdy tripod like this just gives me the insurance that it's not going to fall down and I'm not going to break my camera. So let's take a peek inside the toolbox. So the Chromebook rides on top there, and this is how I have everything laid out. So I have duplicates of everything. If you're going to do this professionally and you have something that goes down, sending a camera out to have it repaired can be weeks. And if you're without your camera, you can't make your content. So it's a little different than if you're going to get serious and do this full time. You want to, you know, buy the best equipment you can get. And if you can get backups on critical components, I would recommend that certainly. So the cameras that I shoot are 5D Mark IVs. These are full frame professional camera Canons with the Pro Media gear cages on them. And I'll show you why that's on there here in a minute. Microphones, I shoot usually two different types of microphones. I use the Rode VideoMic Pros. This is the Pro Plus, and this is the previous gen, I think, right here, for kind of run and gun and shotgun stuff where I don't want to deal with a lav mic. Wind is always a problem, you know, when you're out outside. So being able to have these are called dead cats. They're synthetic fur that prevents wind from getting in and clipping the mic. I use lav mics a lot. Just perfect example. The reason why I have two of these is I've got one that's down. So I usually have two in here, but it's out for repair. So having backups and then protecting my media cards, that's really important. So when I'm done, I'll put everything back and the media cards will go in this waterproof Pelican case. And that's what I'll take in with me, in addition to the stuff that I have on Google Drive from the micro SDs. Lots of batteries. I use action cameras, the Sonys, and all of the various and different components and small tripods and clips and cables and clamps and wires and gaffer's tape and everything that I have learned that I need over the years, from years and years of doing this. But the Chromebook always comes with me and rides right here on top. The Chromebook has become indispensable for me and part of my toolkit because it gives me so many tools to be able to run my business and stay in communication, not only with my family and my wife, but also with you guys. This is how I interface with you guys. This is how I access my channel and answer comments and all of that. And what's so nice about it is that it's really similar to our phones, based on using applications. You can go to the web store, and you can download any application that you want that's going to help you, whether it be the calendar that we use and Google Drive that we use constantly, to the YouTube apps, to video editing, to all of those things. And also it has a touch screen, which is this is the first computer I've ever had that's had a touch screen, and it's very helpful to me in the shop. You know, as when I'm working on the shop, and sometimes I'll do research on videos and a lot of the stuff that I'm learning along with you guys, and I have to go in and to be able to, you know, make sure that I'm doing things right or try different techniques, and to be able to work into the shop and to have a touch screen that I can check. And I'm a visual learner. I like to see things and I get inspired by different things that I see on the web and other creators. And to be able to come up when my hands are covered with sawdust and I'm busy, and just to really quickly have a computer that opens and boots up so quickly and is so simple to use with a touch screen, to me is really nice. It helps with my workflow. It doesn't get in my way. And that's what I look for in tools. I don't want tools to complicate my life. I want tools to make my life easier and simpler. Another feature that we really enjoy using, of course, is the calendar. The calendar is something that Mrs. W in her Chromebook, she can add different events. She can add things that I need to pick up, or things, phone calls that we need to make, and automatically it's shared over the internet. So we communicate on this all the time because we don't have cell coverage out here. So this is the main way that we get information back and forth and stay in touch is through the Gmail app and the texting features. So when you do everything by yourself, like I do, from the video work to the lighting to the audio, everything's got to be simple and easy to use. And this is a system that has been many years in the coming, or that I've come up with that works really good. So everything is based on the Swiss Acura, the quick attach bases. And I want to show you the reason I mentioned the cage on here and how functional this is. So the cameras require lots of different apparatus on there. Sometimes if I shoot in the dark, for example, I need to have lighting. And having multiple tripods and moving everything out, if it's just a one-man guy, it's just too much to do. So I've had to really streamline things in a way that makes them simple. So when I need lighting, for example, if I'm shooting in the metal shop, which is really, really dark, I can't shoot in there without having some light. And so the cage, this is a Pro Media VRC1 Pro Media Gear cage allows me to have all sorts of options. It gives me a carry handle where I can safely carry and move my camera around with. It gives me the ability to mount lights. It gives me the ability, I can mount microphones. Versatility is so, so important. I can add and subtract things, and I'm all about whatever I can do to make my life easier, because I'm trying to do the work and I'm trying to make the videos and I'm trying to deal with light and audio all by yourself, and the storyline is really challenging. So it's got to be easy, it's got to be simple, and it's got to be strong. So that's kind of why the cage and how all of that stuff works. I'm very selective about what goes in this toolbox, the photography toolbox. If it's not something that contributes to my business, to my channel, to giving me the ability to produce good content, it's not in there. I can't have peripheral stuff. I just don't have room for it. And the Chromebook has given me a flexibility to take my channel and to produce content and to do the things that I need to do anywhere. I'm no longer bound by my office. I can do editing. I can do uploading. I can answer comments. I can get information. I can do anything that I need to do, from whether it be my van or if we go up to the mountain and go skiing or for traveling. This is always with me, and it helps me to stay in touch, and it helps me to do everything that I need to do around my channel. I couldn't get by without it. It's a vital component to me. There are so many moving parts and pieces to making video content that organization is so important. Everything in my kit has a place and goes back. When I'm done shooting, the first thing that I do is I insert my cards and I load everything up using the Google Drive app through my Chromebook. And that has everything waiting for me in my home office where I do my main editing. And while that is doing its thing, I put everything back in its spot. I charge all the batteries, I swap everything out. Now, the only variation that I'll make to this kit is sometimes, in the rare occasion that I do need lights, that I will run my lights in here where the camera body goes, and I'll just take this in on the tripod. But I don't often use lights. The new cameras, the full frame sensors, are so good that you can practically shoot in dark. So it's rare that I need lights anymore, but everything goes in, it's ready to go, so that when I close the lid on this, that I know that I can grab it and everything is charged and I'm ready to go. So that wraps up the quick behind the scenes of kind of the tools that I use for creating content. Again, I want to thank Google Chromebook for producing a tool that helps me to stay in communication with you, with my family. Gives me tools and applications that I can take my channel anywhere, and the versatility and flexibility, and where I'm not tied to anything. And I think that's the thing that I enjoy the most about it. So coming up, some uncertainty of what's coming up in the next couple weeks. I am slated on the list to go down to California as an engine boss to help fight the wildland fires down in Los Angeles. I've got a crew put together. And we're just waiting for the call. So we're all packed. 14 days will be minimum. Could be 21 days. I could be down there. But we could be going at any moment or not at all. So I was up all night getting my wildland gear. It's really something to be called out on a wildland fire where I might be not be home for Christmas. I never thought I'd see the day of that. But California really needs help down there. And so we're sending some guys down there to see if we can't. Certainly can't lend a hand. So I'll try, if that's the case, I'll try to vlog from the road. Sorry, my voice is a little shaky. It's freezing in here. Vlog from the road and share that with you. Another good thing is my good friend Alan, he's coming with me. I couldn't be more thrilled about that. It's nice to work with people you trust and implicitly. And I'm really looking forward to that. So we'll try to vlog from the road and give updates. Mrs. W, we'll put some updates up, but that's it. Keep us in your prayers, and thanks for watching. We'll see you guys on the next video.